The British men and women who gave their lives while serving in the armed forces in the 20th century are by and large commemorated well. The Commonwealth War Graves Commission have the dead of the two world wars in their care, and those who fell after the Second World War are remembered most notably by the Armed Forces Memorial at the National Arboretum in Staffordshire, but also through an online Roll of Honour. There is, however, no official recognition for those armed forces personnel who died between the two world wars. When you take the final qualifying date for deaths in the First World War, the 31st of August 1921, and the first qualifying date for the Second World War, the 3rd of September 1939, that adds up to a period of just over 18 years. Men and women serving in the armed forces still died between those years, and British forces were still engaged in combat situations in many different parts of the world. We've located many references to these service personnel in newspaper notices, memorials, and references on family gravestones throughout Scotland. We decided it was time that some of these names were given a more fitting recognition, and in this occasional video series we'll discuss some of the names we've found and look at the stories of some of these forgotten fallen. Our first name came to us through a memorial postcard we obtained. We were really pleased to be able to put a face to a name. We were hopeful that the information on the card would help us to locate more details on Corporal Kidd. The Scotland's People website allows you to look at the death returns of Scottish service personnel, and so from that we were able to add a lot more information to our man. His full name was Corporal William Yates Kidd, service number 286-6264. William was an experienced soldier who had served in the First World War. He had initially joined the Argyll and Sutherland Highlanders, and the medal row indicates he also served in two different battalions of the Seaforth Highlanders before ending up in the Gordons. The service return indicated that his death had occurred as the result of an accident while he was out boating. Another man, Corporal Nidry, had been with him at the time and was registered as the informant to the death. Unfortunately, there are few other details. The only newspaper report we found consists of a single sentence noting his death with no further information. The regimental history for the Gordon Highlanders doesn't mention him. In fact, the time the 1st Battalion spent in Malta in 1922 is the subject of just two paragraphs. It notes their arrival in November 1921, and as well as undergoing training, they participated in a number of sports before they departed for Turkey in July 1922. William is buried in Malta, as at the time repatriation of bodies did not occur. His grave can still be found there today. We hope you found this short video on one of the forgotten fallen to be of interest. Let us know in the comments below what you think of this series, as we hope to do more of them in the future. Please leave a like on the video, it really helps us to build our audience, and do subscribe to our channel to be sure not to miss future videos. Thank you for watching.